Hello everybody, welcome to our channel M&M Gastro Care India. This is Dr. Maya Pidambaran, liver specialist. Today I'm going to give some tips on management of liver cirrhosis. Should we be scared when you have liver cirrhosis? Is liver transplantation the only treatment for liver cirrhosis? So when a patient comes to you with liver cirrhosis, what are the things we look at? The first thing is, what is the cause for the liver cirrhosis? It could be alcohol, it could be fatty liver, it could be viral hepatitis B or C, it could be a problem with copper metabolism, what we call as Wilson's disease, it could be a problem with iron metabolism, that is hemochromatosis. In females, it could also be autoimmune liver disease. Now, whatever is the cause for the liver cirrhosis, it is important to identify it, because treating the cause, be it stopping alcohol, be it treating your fatty liver, that is by weight reduction, treating associated diabetes, hypertension, dyslipidemia, be it treatment of viral hepatitis B and C, we have very good antiviral medications for hepatitis B and C. Treatment of autoimmune liver disease is important. So also iron chelating agents in case of hemochromatosis, copper chelating agents in case of Wilson's, all help in improvement of the liver cirrhosis. So it is very important that we diagnose the cause. Not only we diagnose liver cirrhosis, we also find out what is the cause for the liver cirrhosis. The second question we ask when a patient comes to us with liver cirrhosis is, what is the stage of the liver cirrhosis? Is it stage A, stage B, or stage C? Stage A liver cirrhosis, here there is a structurally the liver is small, but it has not affected the function of the liver. So if you look at the liver function parameters, most of the liver functions may be normal and they usually do not have any complications. So stage A is very compensated, very well compensated stage of liver cirrhosis. Whereas in case of stage B, there is some faltering or there is some problem with the liver functions or the functioning of the liver, so they start developing one or the other complication. It could be a leg edema, it could be increase in your abdominal, it could be abdominal distension. Sometimes patients can also have bleeding. Now, child C or stage C is a bit more advanced stage of liver disease, where they start getting more complications. So the abdominal distension increases, they start getting more of leg edema, they may develop complications like some confused stage, which we call as hepatic encephalopathy. They could develop infection of their fluid in the abdomen, so on and so forth. So once they do into, once they start developing these complications, we label them as stage C. Now, along with the diagnosis of finding out the cause, finding out the stage, it is also important that we treat the complications properly. So it is important to if your abdominal distension is too much, we can do a tapping of the fluid. If there is a significant hepatic encephalopathy or mental confusion, medical measures can be started for that. If there is bleeding, we can do endoscopic banding for those patients. Another thing it important to look into is the important to know that patients with liver cirrhosis can develop liver cancer, so they should be undergoing a screening program which includes a 6-monthly ultrasound abdomen and an alpha fetal protein. Also, patients with liver cirrhosis can develop upper GI bleed or variceal bleed, so they should have a surveillance endoscopy every 6 months to 1 year. So these are the medical measures we should look into. And if you look at the number of patients who would require a transplant, all of child A and most of child B patients would not require transplant. A small proportion of child B and most of the child C patients are whom we would advise a transplant and a liver transplant, and it accounts to only a small proportion of the entire liver cirrhosis population. So what the message I am trying to convey here is that all livers, when you are diagnosed with liver cirrhosis, it is not to be worried about. You need to look, you need to consult your doctor, you need to look into the proper management strategies, proper preventive strategies for your complications. That would help you to lead a normal life. as anybody else. So this is the information I want to share with you, with you all. So if you like this video, please press the like button, subscribe to our channel, and share our video with your friends. Thank you.